lovely to have you with us. Are you a Red Dwarf fan yourself?
I am an absolute Red Dwarf obsessive, to such a tragic extent I can tell you that there are 194 references to either Smeg or the derivative of it in the series so far, and I'm hoping with the next six on Dave, we're going to go over 200. That'd be smegging fantastic.
You're hosting tonight. I mean, what are you expecting from the evening?
Well, I think the great thing about tonight is that as the show starts on Dave tomorrow at 9, this gives the fans the chance, A, to see it first, B, not to tweet about it, like the Olympics, save the secret, and also to ask questions of these fantastic... I mean, Chris Barry, fantastic actor and star. You've got Craig and Robert Llewellyn. I mean, life can get no better. And the man, the co-creator, Doug Naylor. It's like meeting William Shakespeare, Hamlet, Julius Caesar and Macbeth. In space, 3 million years from now, with a human cat who can't be here because he's filming in Guadeloupe. Hey, how mental is that? Even the show, behind the scenes of this show, is mental.
Why do you think it has remained so popular for over two decades?
I think the fantastic thing about Red Dwarf is the way that actually, and it's a simple thing, it was set a million years plus in the future, so it's never going to look dated. Human nature won't change, but this means actually they could do the most stupid business. You watch great shows like The Young Ones, it looks a bit dated now. You watch shows like Bottom, Rick Mayo, Ed Emerson, they look a little bit dated. Red Dwarf will never date because we're still catching up with it.
As you say, the show is completely mad, sort of in front of camera and behind. What would you really like to see in this series?
What I'd love to see, in the first two series, Lister, Craig Charles' character, wore a T-shirt about a cartoon character, Murphy. He turned up briefly in one episode. I told you I was a Trainspotter. I'd love him to have his own spin-off cartoon series, like in a parallel universe, like the Simpsons character we never got to see.
And Paul, what else are you working on at the moment? Is there anything you can tell us about?
I do stuff on Most Haunted Live. Boo! Looking for ghosts that are never going to turn up. I also do This Morning on ITV1. I do some of their showbiz stuff. But tonight, I'm here as a fan. And I must say, of all the jobs I've done in the past 5 years, it's like, take me now, Lord. Life can get no better. Beam me up. Oh, wrong show. Get me up. Get me back on board, Red Dwarf. Yeah, get me back on board, Red Dwarf.